even though the inside's already demoed, we still have a ton of work to do. On the exterior, we need all new siding and paint. Inside, we have to fix the foundation and open up the kitchen to the living room. We also have to turn one of the bedrooms into a main suite with a second bathroom. We have to be pretty careful with the budget on this one. Even though this neighborhood is becoming really popular for families priced out of the nearby Fountain Square, buyers in this neighborhood don't have huge budgets, and we don't want to overbuild or we could lose money.
So this one was $40,000. I would like to say we'll stay in all in under $200,000, but I think we're going to have some pretty significant foundation work.
Yep.
We might be creeping up to $220,000, and I think the sales price is safe at $250,000. Let's get out of here.
All right.
Most of these old houses don't have any OSB or house wrap. It's just siding attached to the 2x4s. It comes off pretty well, and really the most structural thing seems to be the vinyl siding.
Go ahead and do your thing up there. We're gonna stand clear.
There it is.
So me, Corey, and Austin just kind of like stood back. We're like, we're just gonna let you do this and monkey around up in the joists.
Damn monkey! Woo!
Make quick work of that!
Yeah, what are we doing with this?
I don't know.
Is it even tied in there?
I don't think so. Hold on, let me look out here. It's not tied into anything.
Once we got the siding down, you could visualize the porch structure more, or lack thereof. And there wasn't originally a porch. There was just the overhang of the house, and they attached the porch pretty much into the gutter board of the house, which is not sturdy.
See, you got all those different angles. There's no fixing that.
The porch, it needs to be rebuilt.
Oh, hold on. That's a bad idea. Yeah.
Taking down this front porch doesn't necessarily need to be sketchy at all. Tad and the boys just tend to make everything sketchy.
Everyone's so careful.
Tad's just like jump kicking it from inside the house and jumping back in. And then like kicking it and jumping back in.
That's a bad idea. This looks like a bad scene.
From out here.
Give us the four. Yeah, give it over here and we'll pull it. Yeah, gentle.
The good thing is like when I'm extra crazy, Corey's like extra careful.
Yeah, I'm like on high alert. I'm like, hold on.
Tad's
about to get wild.
He's about to break something. Get,
wait a second, Tad.
They got it down. I wouldn't say like wildly successfully, but down and no one got hurt.
Yeah. You're down. That's a big boy.
Yeah, so we were supposed to get a 4-inch beam, but they gave us a 6-inch, and it's big, it's beautiful, and I think we should probably expose it.
I mean, it's got glue all over it though.
Yeah, you just sand that.
We can try to expose it. You guys can see if you can make it pretty. Worst case scenario.
We wrap it.
We wrap it or just paint it white so it blends in with the ceiling.
Just be a good statement piece when you walk in. I think my design intuition is fantastic and
it'll be
wonderful.
Was that your idea or was that Corey's idea? Because he fancies himself a designer too.
He does. I think we're both trying to step into the ring.
All right, it's looking good.
All right.
Now that framing is done, the team has started installing new siding and drywall.
We have a local couple, Brian and Emily, who have the house under contract based on only the floor plans, so they put a lot of trust in us.
So we really want to make sure we give them something that they'll love.
Nothing that I'm needing right now. Everything is perfect somehow.
I just love the colors. I'm from the beach, so like it's got the beachy vibe to it. So.
It was just not approachable. It had a chain link fence that was all overgrown with stuff. So now it's very like happy, approachable, nice porch to sit
on. Very welcoming.
Gave you an all new facade, but kept a lot of the details. So there was that diamond up there before. We just replaced it with new materials.
Okay.
And then the two windows we kept, detailed the trim a little bit.
Okay. Oh my God.
I'm gonna go see the inside?
Yes.
Yes,
yes. Yes.
When we got it, it was all demoed inside. And we didn't have to do a whole lot of reframing. We obviously opened up this wall and then made some adjustments to where the openings were here.
I love that you kept the beam exposed.
Yes.
And didn't cover that up.
It was one of like the load-bearing things we had to have to open up these two rooms. Mm-hmm. So keeping that exposed, we did a really nice white stain on it.
They burnt it.
They did burn it.
So fire, and that's how you get that grain coming out.
Okay.
We have the EVP flooring that goes throughout the entire house.
Yes.
There's no breaks that go to tile anywhere, which really help it feel a lot bigger as well.
Oh man,
this looks so good. Would you like to get a closer look at the kitchen?
Yes.
That's my happy place.
Oh my God.
Oh my gosh.
This is one huge slab of tree.
Oh my gosh.
That's amazing. Incredible.
So you've got some island height prep space and then seating down here. And then we cut the live edge so it has this really organic shape.
Really?
Wow.
And it's kind of like the showstopper furniture piece.
Yes.
Yeah. I want to keep touching it.
So this is all very pretty, but like we also do have a really pretty kitchen. Double stack cabinets on one side,
tons of storage.
Some open shelving on the other side, quartz countertop, so super durable, kind of looks like marble and has that movement.
And then nice farm sink. Your backsplash is just a little fun.
It's very easy to clean. Wow.
Much
They're
easier
all big
to clean.
Tiles.
Wow.
So you love it?
Any complaints so far?
No.
Zero.
Yes!
We did some adjustments specifically for you guys on the mudroom because you wanted a place to wash your pups.
Yes.
And it's super cute back there now, so come check it out.
Super cute. Oh my goodness!
That was
perfect!
So I feel like for your size pups, that works.
Yes.
But we did have to, we adjusted the closet back, we stacked the washer and dryer so we could get this fit in there.
Yeah. Exactly what we wanted.
We
so this
it.
Is what you guys,
yes. Yeah.
All right, I'm glad this worked out
No more breaking our backs in the shower to do it.
Yeah. Do you want to take a quick peek out at the backyard?
Yes.
All right, much prettier now.
Oh yeah.
Oh wow. Yeah, the dogs are really gonna enjoy this.
Yeah, it's a big backyard.
Big backyard.
Yes.
And when you're ready for trees, let me know.
Okay.
I'll point you in the right direction.
Absolutely. Yeah, that's perfect.
Let's go take a look at your upstairs bonus space.
The first thing I want you to notice is this little three-legged table.
Okay.
Because that's made from the maple tree that was in the backyard that we had to take down.
Okay.
Oh, that's so cute.
So this is your little chill space.
Yes. Perfect.
You need a break at the end of a hard day. This could be your space. Yep. He doesn't even get to come up here.
No,
I'm upstairs.
That's normal.
Leave me alone.
Can put your gate and keep
you
the dogs out
or whatever you want. So love the little bonus space, but we still have your bedroom and bathroom to see.
Yeah.
You guys want to go back down?
Yes, please.
And your main ensuite.
Oh my goodness.
Wow.
I love the windows. They bring in so much natural light. Yeah.
Super tall ceilings.
Which is amazing.
Wow. I
love it.
And the barn door.
Yes. So the barn door was another one of those custom-made items. Did a little bit of burning to bring the grain out and then did the white stain on there too.
Love it.
They were cute.
Awesome.
Do you want to check out your bathroom?
Yes.
So take a peek on in. We've never used tile quite like this before.
Oh my goodness.
Wow. The fish scale from the top that's just in the shower.
Oh, wow. I love how it goes all the way up to the ceiling.
Yeah.
Yes.
That just makes it feel so big.
Exactly. It feels huge.
Wow.
And it feels a little beachy.
It does. Yeah. The double vanity is perfect.
Yes.
Oh,
this
I love
is beautiful.
It.
Yeah.
It's all working?
Yeah.
It is.
Do you guys want to go back in the kitchen and look at the table again?
Sure.
We can talk
about
it.
Yeah.